What is going on, guys? We here with more World Cup. We got Roses vs Medi Brolic, and apparently if Roses loses this game, I think there's a tiebreaker between West Germany. I don't know if there's a there might be a third country in that too. But I'm not 100% sure how that works. But I just read up in the thread, and US Central cannot make next round anymore. But yeah, we see Medi Brolic, he got subbed in for, I don't know for who. Is that gonna be Scarf Garchomp or Scarf Hooper, right? I can see Zimu for Shachel Hooper too. And I'm thinking more so Scarf Jump, to be honest. And then yeah, Rocks Lando, Rocks Mew. Probably Rocks Lando. Yeah, not sure which one is the Z-move user. Could be Magina, could be Hooper. I don't think it's Garchomp, I think Garchomp has to be Scarf, right? So Rose's team, Almamola has that young wish path for his friends Heatran, Garchomp, and he also has grassy terrain. So Heatran, if it has lefties, it's gonna stay healthy. It might be Shachel Heatran. I've used Shachel Heatran before with we have grassy terrain support from Bulo. Why does Bulo look so small compared to some like Almamola? Your grassy terrain recovery from this. So you have like technically you have lefties on your Heatran if you have Shachel, even though you don't have lefties, thanks to grassy terrain, right? And what else am I trying to say? Yeah, you also have wish pass from Almamola. It's Earthquake Mew. Oh my God. Medi Brolic showing wild sets turn 1. So he's playing for US Metro, I think. Roses on US West. I think they are 15 and 14, so if they win they are guaranteed to be next round of players, however you want to call it. I don't know what the score is for US Metro though. Is he defog on this? He has to be defog on this. Yeah, nice. So the trend just took a lot of damage and the rocks are not on the field, so that worked out pretty nice. Is this the Everyone KOs Heatran team? Earthquake on this, Earthquake on this, Earthquake on this is what PDC is saying. And then like, if PDC is right, it's gonna be like Focus Blast, Z Focus Blast or maybe. And I don't know what Hooper is. Hooper also beats Heatran 101. Yeah, it's interesting why he wasn't starting. I think Medi Brolic is pretty good, but he is not I think he doesn't wanna play that much Pokemon at the moment. I think he has like other plans. Let me close my Discord. I'm not trying to like lag out or anything because I'm on slow internet. You said he was only gonna use Wax. Yeah, like Medi Brolic, he wanted to meme, I think. I think that, yeah, that's probably why I didn't, one of the reasons why I didn't start. Who did he get subbed in for? I have no idea. I just want to see the game. Whew. So Roses, this could be three attack Zapdos. Three attack Zapdos with Roost. And then Defog Mew. He went for Heatwave, I don't know what he expected. Maybe he expected him to go into Tangrowth, predicting a Discharge? That's an option, yeah. I think he predicted that. But yeah, the Burn Nerf helps the Zapdos a lot. So it's Will-O-Wisp, Earthquake, Defog, and then it's gonna be Softball in the last slot. I kinda like Earth Power a little bit better on Mew, because if you get burned, Earthquake is not gonna do any damage. But I guess it's fine. He goes Hard Hoop on the Heatwave. No burn. Whew. Okay, so where is the switch in? Where is the switch in, my friend? I'm not sure if this is if it's Specs or Bennett, it doesn't have good switch ins. but I'm not sure if it's Shed Shell or if it's like Z-Move, man. I'm just super interested to see where this is. I can't wait to see the set. Just put in some work, my man. I mean, if it's Hyperspace Fury, the only potential switch would be the Tapu Bulu. But even that might take a lot. Almighty Maddie. My man PTB's still up, it's like 5 in the morning for him. Yeah, so by the way, I should talk a bit about BTB. He built teams for like some of the World Cup teams for Asia and Germany, I think. And I think his teams, he's told me, they are 13-1. That's pretty nice. Earlier I knew they were 11-1, but I think they picked up 2 more wins. Whew, it's Liddy. Like, Zapdos definitely loses to Hooper 1-on-1, like... If he thinks it's... He goes for a dark move, he's obviously gonna go Tapu Bulu, but... I'm not really sure what else he could do. Like, what if he goes for Gang Shot expecting the Tapu Bulu, then you look like a fool. It's a tough spot, man. I would not want to be in this position. Because Hooper is like a scary mon. Like, Hooper, you don't see it often. So, like, when I team build, I don't really think about Hooper. Like, I need a Hooper switch in. That's not what I think about. I mean, even if I would want a Hooper switch in, Hooper doesn't really have switch ins. So you either have to play aggressive to not give it free switch ins to get in mons that force it out, or you have to go for crit paras. Oh my fucking god, he got the para. Oh my god, so lucky. Dude, I said crit para, but I didn't even see the para yet. I just said crit when I see the I don't know if I saw the crit yet when I said crit para, but I did not see the para coming. I was just hoping he wouldn't get the para. I just said, you have to go for crit para. And he, oh my god, I should not have said that he got it. Well, there goes the Hooper. So a crit at 53, which means a non-crit is like, it kills, a non-crit kills. You can try to roost here, get a para and get this Zapdos healthy, but I think he should just attack. I don't think Heatwave... How much did Heatwave the 25, right? No, that was to the Mew. Heatwave the 27 to Hooper, okay. So Heatwave will kill. Yeah, I would click Heatwave here because it's not really worth to click Roost and bank on the para, because if he doesn't get paralyzed, you just take more damage on your Zapdos. And if you click, well, I don't know what I was trying to say. I think I was trying to say I would click Heatwave because it covers the pivot into the Tangrowth, and it covers the Midjourna. It has a 10% burn chance in case he goes into one of his ground types, but that's not, please don't burn. Yeah, he just picks it up with a discharge. Oh well, that sucked. I mean, it's 30%, but still. Without the crit, he would have been at, I don't know if he would have been in a range from another discharge without the crit. It might have been a roll. But yeah, he's gonna go into Garchomp maybe? But Roses kinda has a free switch into the Almamola. If the Garchomp is Scarf. So the Hooper did 60% of the Zapdos. I assume it's the Specs Hooper. Let's just try, like, we have to take those information that we got and we gotta figure out the sets, right? So discharge is 27 to 32 to the Hooper. Heatwave to 27. So he was definitely offensive. I don't know how offensive he was though. Because if he's max special attack. Yeah, if he's max special attack, there was a low roll. And Dark Pulse does 68 to 84. So how much did Dark Pulse do? It did 60, right? It did 60. It does 68 to max HP. So I guess he wasn't specs then. I can see this not being specs. Maybe it was Scarf Hooper. And maybe the Zapdos was offensive. And how much does it do? Yeah, if the Hooper is Scarf and the Zapdos has no bulk investment, then it could be Scarf Hooper. So this could be SDZ move, but I'm not sure. Scarf Hooper is so weird. Dude, how did he beat Volcarona? If you're not Scarf Garchomp. Yeah, he just goes Alabamola. Nice double into Tangrowth, but that Hex just sucked. Maddie was in a good position at first. But yeah, he's playing as well. He's probably gonna click knock off your right. So I can see Alabamola going for Toxic. Depending on how valuable Rosas thinks his leftovers are, I assume there's gonna be leftovers. Standard Alabamola. It's definitely gonna be Wish Protect, and then it's either Knockoff and Toxic or Skull and Toxic. He goes into this predicting a Knockoff, and he's gonna be Z move. He goes for Earthquake, so he expected him to go on a Heatran or. Yeah, I think he expected him to go on a Heatran. Yeah, and I think Rose expected a Knockoff, and he went hard into this. So that's probably Z move. I mean, pretty obvious if you look at a team. This probably Scarf Chomp too. Like I think Maddie's is not Scarf. Like the, because the way the Hooper damaged versus Zapdos, that just made sense that the Hooper. I mean the Hooper was not a boosting item, which makes me think that it might be Scarf Hooper, but I'm not sure yet. Could also be Scarf Chomper. But yeah, you can. They don't really carry Sludge Bomb. Not that often. I don't think this Garchomp has Poison Jab. I haven't seen that in a while. So, how is Maddie gonna kill this? I guess maybe go hard into Landorus. But if he has Bloom Doom and he clicks Bloom Doom predicting a switch, it's gonna do 5 million. If he's offensive Landorus, it might Oko. How much does Bloom Doom do from Tapu Bulu to offensive Landorus? Let's say he's offensive Flylando. Let's say Z Woodhammer. That just Okos. They're like. In case he predicts the Tapu Bulu to go for Sword Stance, he goes hard into offensive Landorus. Oh my god! Holy shit, Medi Brodick the god. How does he do it? I think Roses scouted for Sludge Bomb. I think he scouted for Sludge Bomb, which is why he went in Heatran. And I don't know what else he was predicting, because if Manny was going into Landorus there, or into like. I don't know what he was predicting, I have no idea. Other than Sludge Bomb. He was predicting Sludge Bomb, yes, that makes sense. But I don't know if Heatran would have covered a potential double switch too. I guess he just wanted to get his Heatran in on a potential double switch or on a Sludge Bomb to get some grassy terrain recovery. Was it revealed if the Heatran had lefties, by the way? Yeah, I think the Heatran had lefties, yeah. But yeah, this game is really cool. I would have never made that play, because I thought, what if he has these, like... Yeah, now he's in trouble. But getting rid of the Hitron was fire, because he kept rocks off. But... If he was I was just thinking about if he's Sky Strike Lander, he could go hard on the Landers on the SD. But he just went for Earthquake, man, just didn't care, and it worked out. Like, you guys see, Hidden Power doesn't do enough. Bulu beats this one-on-one. Why didn't... Is he not Z-move Lando? Or he gets a crit but still doesn't kill? What is this Z-move user? He can just click Holy Chi and he's gonna get so much health back. Like, he's gonna get so much health back, you cannot imagine. This is gonna be like 70 with Holy Leech. Oh, they're talking about this Rocky Helmet become... This Rocky Helmet activate before healing. Yeah, Rocky Helmet activates first, but I'm pretty sure this is not Rocky Helmet. It's AV, right? So, okay, he's... Lava said no PDC healing is first. Okay, I'm not sure about that. Yeah, I think I've seen it once and healing went first, but I don't remember. Yeah, it's a bit weird if you don't use Sludge Bomb, Tangrowth. Like, if you have AV Tangrowth and you don't have Sludge Bomb, you don't beat Tapu Bulu one-on-one, which is really weird, because you should beat it one-on-one, right? You're a Tangrowth. You're, like, bulky and stuff. Yeah, I like this. I also use Rock Slide sometimes for Volcarona and Zard Y. Some people just throw their Zard Y in there, like... Because they look at my team and they look like, oh yeah, I can bring this in for free in Tangrowth. Not really can bring it, I can't really bring it in for free on anything else, so I'm gonna bring it in on Tangrowth and then hit that Rock Slide button. I mean, it only works on a ladder. I don't think it would work in a tour game. He's just, if he has only, just gonna click it, right? I don't know who of the two is thinking so long. There's no timer. I think Matty Brolic is taking his time here, because it's tough for him. Because it gets so much back from the Horn Leech that it's going to be able to eat up the next Hidden Power anyway. If he's offensive Lando, man, he should have just... If he has like Sky Strike or something, he should have just gone dead on the SD. But now he goes into Lando's, is going to get bopped by the Horn Leech, yep. Gets back to 78, 76. Dang. We don't see Rocky Helmet. I'm thinking it was a Z-move user. And if it was Sky Strike, he could have gone into that on the SD. I know it's risky and all that. But like, the first time he did an SD, it was pretty obvious that he would SD the second time. Doesn't McGinn die to the Z? If it has Z Woodhammer, it's gonna die. With Z Woodhammer, this Megina is gonna disappear into another dimension. You do not play around with Tapu Bulu. Like, I don't even have to calc this. I know the Grassy Terrain is gone, but it's a +3 Tapu Bulu. I wanna run the calc though. Tapu Bulu, Megina. I'm not sure if it's max HP. I'm gonna calc max HP. +3, no grassy terrain, adamant, woodhammer, Z. Wait, that is only to 40%. That makes no sense. Yes, he Bloom Doom kills. He crit. I don't know if the crit mattered. Like, I told you guys, it's gonna kill. It's gonna disappear. I told you. It's a fucking Bloom Doom. Oh, I put plus 3 in defense, that's why I did nothing. Yeah, Bloom does 104 if it's Z Wood Hammer. But if it's Z Horn. If it's Z Horn Leech, I'm pretty sure it's Z Wood Hammer. Because that's just the set that you use with that. But yeah, if it's Horn Leech, the crit mattered. Pretty sure it was Wood Hammer though. So yeah, Tapu Bulu turned this game around, like. Holy shit. If it was Z Wood Hammer, it didn't even matter, the crit. That's crazy. Yeah, the game is over. I think West is 16-14 if Roses wins this. Like, Roses is gonna win. I don't see how he cannot come back from this. So I don't think West has to go to playoffs, and I don't know what happens with Team Germany if they are out with 15-15 or if they get a tiebreak. These guys are posting a Kalk in grassy terrain, but grassy terrain was run out. Yes, the terrain was gone, exactly. But Hornleach without terrain still has a good chunk. At least the terrain is gone, so the Bulu doesn't heal health back, but also the Tangrowth doesn't heal, so I guess you can set it for both. Yeah, I mean, he's forced to spam HPS, what else is he gonna do? This probably doesn't even twit KO with the health that he gets back from the next Horn Leech. Oh boy. This Tapu Bulu just clean swept him. Yeah, this Tapu Bulu is getting thumbnail, like. I find it kinda hard to find new Tapu Bulu pictures, I only have like 2 or 3. They kinda look the same. Cause like I put Bulu in the thumbnail quite often, but I just don't find any new pictures. I get the crits to like wrap it up even more, but I don't think that mattered. I don't know what they think. Like, that didn't matter, dude. I mean, they're trolling. The only hex, like, we don't know what would have happened if he didn't get the crit para on the Hooper. That was definitely annoying. So yeah, the only thing that matters if, yeah, you have to know if it was Z Wood Hammer or Z Horn Leech. Cause it was I don't know why we even talking about this, like, it's pretty obvious that it's Z Wood Hammer. Like, that's not a set. Yeah, exactly. Double grass. That's the only set. If you run Woodhammer, like if you run Bloomdom, you run Woodhammer Horn Leech. I don't know what you run in the last slot, either Superpower or Zen Headbutt. Or, I don't know. Probably Superpower or Stone Edge, depending on what you're weak to or what you want to hit. What you try to snipe on the switch. Wait, Germany's in playoffs. Oh. If CNN gets activity, East Germany, LA, Europe, France, West, and Italy, Spain are playoffs. Yeah, it will happen. We will see what happens, who goes to playoffs. Thank you guys for watching. This might have been the last game of the night. I think there's like a few games left, but I don't know if they will all play. Some people have like need subs in. Wait, Roses winning guaranteed Germany to be in the next round? I thought Roses winning was bad for Germany. Okay, I'm actually not sure then. I thought it was bad for Germany that he won. Is Germany next round? That, I guess that's pretty cool if they are. I'm not 100% sure. Like I said in a few of my videos, I might make a video about the next round, about the playoff thing. Like, just to inform you who made it to that, and also talk a bit about the matchups, at least for the tiers that like Sun and Moon and Auras. Yeah, I think Germany's next round, that's fire. Or playoffs, however you want to call it. Thank you guys for watching, and I see you with a lot more content. Hope you all enjoyed, and peace out, friends.